program unlike any other. Stories you think you know and stories you should know. Covering Colorado with an eclectic mix of profiles, commentaries, and all speed features. On this episode, our daughter takes a slice of Denver pop culture as we find things to do in Denver when you're dead. But first, Lucha Libre takes it to the Met.
Lucha Libre is this traditional Mexican wrestling. It's been going on for about 100 years. A luchador is the wrestler, right? So they're a big guy, usually with a mask, so they don't have to have it. That tradition of the mask is that we don't know who they are when they're in real life, and they can go out and work and have a family and keep that sort of mysterious. The luchador is, you know, that's your point of entree of how you find who you want to follow, or if you like Rudos or Technicos, which are the bad guys or the good guys. His role is to land people down on the mat for a count of three, or make them submit, or kick them out of the ring for a count of 20, or however else he's going to win a fall. My name is Jason Sobel, also known as Sid Pink, also known as the Steel of Rojillo. Well, how I got involved at all in the local lucha scene actually happened from working with people I'm partnered with on a documentary about Lucha Libre, ISO production, Chris Bagley and Kim Scheidler.
Wrestling is fake. Has to step in the ring and has to be been body slammed or been choked out or been hit with a steel chair in the forehead.
Me and Juan from the only luchador here in Colorado. I started training this week.
This is my dad. I started wrestling since I was 2 and I'm 15 years old right now.
No hay malos ni buenos luchadores. Simplemente hay luchadores profesionales y luchadores amateurs.
The demand is starting to grow recently in Denver.
It's like gambling. Some days you do like a big show and it turns out good and everyone's happy, then other days.
My job is here, Lucha Libre in Denver. Whatever I do, I gotta get paid. This is my living.
If things go the way I'm thinking they're going to go, then we're taking Lucha Libre all around the U.S.
My hope for the future of Lucha Libre in Denver is that the scene will continue to grow, that more kids of any background will take it seriously and get involved with it, that there will become enough of a sort of sustainable here that it will draw new audience to it, and that maybe eventually there'll be some notoriety of it.